Hi there. In this video, we are going to be taking a look at this Parkside from Lidl Jigsaw. It's a PSTD 800B2. And yeah, about it, 800 watts, 3100 movements per minute, and it can cut 80 millimeters of wood or 8 millimeters of metal, and I'm expecting maybe 8 or 10 in plastic. And it has a pendulum action, and it should be adjustable. I will see exactly from where, from here. To cut into soft metals, soft materials like soft wood a bit faster, for example. And yeah, 3 wood saw blades, 1 metal saw blades, parallel fence, hex key, and reducer piece for extraction nozzle. That should be all of the things that are in this box, but as you can see, the cable is 3 meters. Just want to add that. This is not new. I'm making this video because this thing is really good, works really well. And I bought for myself one of these battery powered ones, and my father is using this, and I want to see if I made the right choice by buying that thing, or this is still better. One thing that I know for a fact that it's better, it has a laser guideline, which it's a shame this doesn't have it, but yeah, I don't have wires, so I'm happy about that. Anyway, so let's get into this. As you can see, slightly used, not abused, in absolute perfect working order, although it has been used for several years and lots of cuts. Again, 3 meter cable, or so they say. I don't have any reason to believe they are lying. From here you adjust the pendulum motion, zero, no pendulum on hard materials and really clean cuts, softer materials, worse cuts, really soft material with the worst possible cut, worst possible from this three version. Doesn't mean that it will make really jagged edges. That depends on you to see on the material you are working. You need to test it. Okay, this thing releases or opens up. One moment, this I'm not sure what it does. Be back in a second. Okay, so if you connect a vacuum to this, you need to switch this in here. If not, it remains in off position. That's what it does. As you can see, this thing has a quite beefy motor. This thing, on the other hand, has a really tiny motor in here, but it's a completely different type of motor, so that might not mean that much. Anyway, another difference between them, this is used to actually lock, I cannot do it with one hand, I will show in a second. You can see, for example, now this is locked and it's working continuously. And yes, it has a really nice rubber finish on it, even on the button itself. So that's nice. This also has it, but not on the button. Anyway, button. So if you want to unlock the button, you need to push on it and it unlocks. On this other one, it's the complete opposite. You cannot push it until you press on that, and then you can push it. But I'm not going to do that because the battery is connected and it will actually start. So they are completely different things. For this one, you adjust the RPM, or the thing similar to RPM, because they are not rotations, they are up and down movements. The speed of the movements, you set it from here, and this is just a dumb switch. On this one, the speed is controlled by how much you push this switch, so it doesn't have any other adjustment like this. Two different ways of reaching the same thing. From here, you start the laser itself, which is awesome, and it's right down there, and also the LED, which is right down there. So from the same switch, you do both of those things. to put a blade in, this has, let me show you on the other side actually, has this lever which you actually rotate like this. And when you rotate the lever, come on camera focus, you can put a new blade in and then you leave it and it locks. But this, because of that type of mechanism, can only use this type of blade. Mine, on the other hand, it's friction locked. And yes, a video, a link for this video will be put in the description of this one and vice versa. Mine can also use this type. So that's good, but yeah, not that important. But I don't have the laser anyway, that I really wish I would have had on it. And I just noticed this screw is not tight. So a small error on the production line. I need to tell my father to tighten it anyway. And to unlock this thing, you need that little guy right there, which is obviously included in the package and which in theory is stored right here. Come on, right there, something. But my father hates this, so he keeps it in the box. And I kind of do agree. I hate that too also. This thing has a lever on the side, so that is a bonus there. Anyway, and yeah, it's harder to rotate this to cut at an angle because you need to undo two screws, adjust it, tighten the screws. That's a lever and you are done. So, yeah. What else? Let's see. These things use this so you can cut along an edge. And you simply slide it in here. Yes, you should undo the screw before sliding it in. I think both screws, so this goes from one side to the other, but I'm only undoing one to demonstrate. If I could undo it enough to get this to work in there. Anyway, like this, adjust it to whatever you need and you are able to cut following an edge. Yes, the cut will not be 100% perfect. These things are not meant for perfect cuts. For that you need something with a circular blade. This is a tool mostly for smaller jobs where the straightness of your cut is not that crucial. And yeah, we have here a steel protection so you don't get stuff in there too easily. But I always hated about this thing, the cable. But this is with any cutting tool, there is a chance if you are not a careful person yourself to cut into the cable. With this, that disappears, that possibility. But anyway, this you just pick up and go, and as long as you have 220 volts you can cut with this. If you don't charge your batteries, it will not cut. Anyway, this has a bent metal plate on the bottom. This is probably cast aluminum or magnesium, something like that. And this has the plastic on it with screws directly from the start, so you do not scratch what you are cutting on. This thing on the other side, release, okay, has this clip-on thing when you are cutting something delicate and you do not want to scratch it. My father doesn't keep it on, but yeah, that's for him to decide. And this is to show you where you are cutting, but you have the laser, so this is quite useless. This might help you in real soft materials that you do not create splinters. This plastic. Mine also had something, you can see them down there, but it cracked the moment I tried to install it on. So I'm not going to use it anymore. You will see that in the video for this. This has a protection that you can get in here, which I honestly don't know why my father is not using. because this seems quite easy to use. You just push it in there and there where, and when you need to change the, actually no, not even, yeah, I will tell him to use it, because they were thoughtful enough to give you room for this. I have no idea why he never used it. I will put it in here, maybe he doesn't notice and it remains there as a protection. This has one that flips up. I think this has a bigger chance of breaking compared to this one, which is a clip-on, but anyway. What else? Yes, the blades that you get it with. And this adapter for various other vacuum size. It makes it a bit smaller. For mine, it's one size, and yeah, the adapter would also work for mine. So it means this probably is the same size as this. And if you need to see the info on it, this is it. And that's about that. And ooh, 2019. So this thing has been used for about 2 years now, and going strong, which is perfect, exactly as you would want from a tool. And my hand is shaking quite badly, so I'm sorry about that. I'm not sure why. I'm a bit tired, probably. Anyway, that's that. All the accessories, this thing. Now let's go cut something with this one, cut something with this one, and give you my final answer of which one of the two I actually prefer to use. I hope it's that one, because it's mine and it's cordless, but we will see. Okay, did two small initial cuts just to get a feel on for this tool. First one, this one, was with exact mode, and this one was with speed mode. And yes, in this soft wood, with speed mode, I think you are cutting 2 or 3 times faster than with the exact, but as you can see, the end results is way worse, because if on this one, if I clean up everything in here, basically it's decently clean. In this one, yeah, you get this. So yep, soft wood if you want a clean cut, exact mode. If you want a fast cut, go with speed. In hardwood, speed will probably not work well no matter what you do. On the bottom side, the cuts are quite similar, so here we don't see any difference. So that's that. Let me see, show it to you while actually working on exact mode. Yes, you need to push on this, and it works even at slow speed. You can see the light in there. In theory, you shouldn't stop or start it when it's already cutting, but in reality, trying to adjust the speed to really slow speed, for example, you might actually stall it. But at least in this wood, I don't feel for a second that it wouldn't be powerful enough or something to restart. So, yep, until now really good, and quite less noisy than I expected it to be. Less noisy than main powered ones. So, let me play a bit with the main powered one and get back then to this. Okay, we have a fail. Actually, you cannot change the blade because it's hitting the plastic, and you cannot push it enough to change it. So this cannot always stay on. You need to take it out when you are actually changing the blade, which is a bummer. Okay, about the lights, with this switch, press once LED and laser. Press again, only LED, only laser, and off. Okay, this laser light is really nice, so you can follow a line extremely easy, even in daylight. If it would be directly sun onto this, maybe I cannot see it. But in normal daylight without direct sun, I can see it, no issues whatsoever. So this is quite nice. Made 2 cuts, one without pendulum mode and one with pendulum mode at max. You can clearly see the difference. This one without pendulum mode, this is softwood. It's fairly nice. On the bottom, I think they are, yeah, they are identical. Cannot really see differences, maybe in straightness. But anyway, but the pendulum one, yeah, pieces of wood all around, and you cannot really clean this up to look as nice as this one, no matter what you do anymore. So yeah, depending on your finish, be careful about that mode. But overall, on the clean cut mode, I have a feeling that this one actually cuts faster. So not really sure what's up with that. On this mode, I have the feeling that this one cuts faster. So yeah. Okay, let's give it a bell. It's at 4. And no pendulum mode. Decent cut, decently fast, but again, that one seems to be a bit faster on this mode. But the difference is really, really small. Okay, so done my test. The weight is the same between this and the cordless one, at least the one that I get. Working about the same. So if you don't mind this and you like to always have it ready to work as much as you need, get this one. If you don't like cables like I don't, get the other one. But as a tool itself, really good. So yeah, hope my video helps somebody out there, in which case please give it a like, check out my other videos, and as always, see you in the next one. Bye.